Welcome to the safari ride here at the Wildwood Wildlife Park. During the safari, we ask that you remain seated at all times, keeping your arms, head, feet, and all body parts inside the tram. Feeding the animals is strictly prohibited, and please, absolutely no littering on the safari. Please keep a secure hold of cameras and phones. If something does happen to drop outside of the tram during the safari, please do not get up. Notify the tram driver upon exiting the tram at the end of the ride, and your item will be retrieved by one of our staff. Eland are the largest and slowest African species of antelope in the world. They are native to the open plains of eastern and south Africa. They are herbivores and graze mainly on grasses. The males have a thicker, more prominent spiral horn and a thick growth of hair on the forehead, which distinguishes them apart from the female species. The most impressive part of the eland's anatomy is its horns, which can grow up to 3 feet in length. Males use these horns to butt heads with other males during rut, and females use their horns to protect their young from predators. Other distinctive features include a dewlap and a unique clicking sound they make when they walk. The dewlap is loose skin that hangs from the neck of the animal, which is a form of protection from other predators. Their feet make the clicking sound the eland bears down on the hooves. It is used as a form of communication and can be heard more than a mile away. The female eland has a gestation period of 9 months, and one calf is typically born. The mother is quite happy tucking a newborn calf away while she grazes, and the calf has a natural instinct to remain still and hidden so as not to be spotted by predators. Eland are currently not listed as endangered, and their population is stable. The eagle is the second largest living bird on Earth after the ostrich, and is found only in Australia. They can grow between 5 to 6 feet in height and can weigh up to 130 pounds. The sound made by males is similar to a pig's grunt, while females make loud booming noises. The eagle cannot fly, but is a fast runner, holding out its tiny wings hidden under the feathers to serve as stabilizers. They can reach speeds up to 30 miles per hour. Their long legs enable them to walk considerable distances or outrun danger. They defend themselves with their forward kick, which is incredibly powerful. Eagles are also excellent swimmers and have no problem crossing rivers or streams. Male eagles incubate the eggs. During incubation, which typically lasts 56 days, the male will not eat, drink, or defecate. Once the male starts sitting, most females leave the territory, sometimes pairing with other males and laying in newborn clutches. The eagle's conservation status is considered stable. Scimitar horned orcs are desert-adapted antelope roaming the Sahara and Sahel regions of northern Africa. They get their name from their elegant horns that curve backwards like a scimitar's horn. Both males and females have horns. Their black skin helps protect them against sunburn, while enlarged hooves enable orcs to walk easily on sand. Their dense eyelashes and strong eyelids protect against wind-blown sand in the desert. To deal with the desert heat, the scimitar horned orcs can tolerate an internal body temperature of 116 degrees Fahrenheit. They are able to go without drinking for 9 to 10 months, which allows them to conserve water and thrive in the desert. The scimitar horned orcs is now extinct in the wild, but through zoo breeding programs, appropriate habitat reintroductions have begun in Africa.
Okay, these are the doll sheep over here. I'm going to clean them in a minute, but if you look just up that rock ledge, and then in about 3 feet, you'll see one of the babies is sitting there behind the mother.
Oh, yeah. Doll sheep live in extremely cold and harsh climates at high altitudes, up to 6,500 feet. They inhabit northwestern parts of Canada and the northern parts of the United States and Alaska. The sheep's fine white woolly coat helps to camouflage them against the snowy, rocky habitat and provides protection against extreme temperatures. Males are called rams and females are called ewes. Males will kick and slam each other using their horns. To prevent brain injuries, males have several hair cushions in the head which absorb the impact of the hit. Their horns take up to 8 years to grow and are composed of keratin, the same material that's in our fingernails. The age of the sheep can be calculated from the number of growth rings on their horns, much like a tree. The hooves are hard on the outside edges with a spongy center that provides traction and grip on steep, rocky terrain. Split hooves also allow them to quickly ascend and descend steep slopes to evade predators. Dall sheep status is allowed to stable and is not listed as endangered. New to our safari in 2018 are the Arabian oryx. Most Arabian oryx live in Saudi Arabia, Iraq, Oman, Yemen, Jordan, and Kuwait. They are built specifically for desert environments. Their fur is white to reflect the hot sun. Living in the desert is definitely tough. Food and water are difficult to find, so they have adapted to going a long time without drinking water. The oryx gets a supply of water from the plants they eat. They also are equipped with wide feet to help them stay on top of the desert sand rather than sinking in. They have long, straight horns, and some say that this animal was the model of the legendary unicorn. In 1972, poachers in Oman killed the last wild Arabian oryx. After extensive conservation efforts with zoos and private preserves, the Arabian oryx was reintroduced into the wild starting in 1980. In 1986, the oryx was classified as endangered, and in 2011, it was the first animal ever to revert to vulnerable status after being listed as extinct in the wild. In 2011, populations were estimated at over 1,000 individuals in the wild and 6,000 to 7,000 individuals in zoos and wildlife preserves worldwide. This is one of the most successful stories of conservation recovery of this decade. Bighorn sheep's current range is the foothills of Nevada from the San Jacinto Mountains near Palm Springs, California to the U.S.-Mexico border. They are members of the Bovid family. Both male and female sheep have horns. But the male's horns are massive and weigh as much as 30 pounds themselves. Their horn is made up of a bony core attached.
Okay, the baby bighorn sheep is just to the right of the opening there. Where the rocks kind of come down and go over. It's laying there, right in that little opening.
The skull permanently, unlike deer that shed their antlers. The females are called ewes, the males are called rams. They have split hooves, which aid in balance, and rough hoof bottoms for natural grip as they move around the rugged mountain terrain. At the beginning of the 19th century, there were between 1.5 million to 2 million bighorn sheep in North America. Today, there are less than 70,000. With the private and public conservation breeding programs, the sheep population is slowly being reestablished.
Okay, the bongo are right up here on our left, right underneath these trees. Bongo are herbivores. They eat grasses and leaves. They have a tongue that's capable of wrapping around the branches and actually stripping the leaves right off of it. As I said earlier, we normally haven't been able to see them this close up, so this is really kind of a treat today. We put them in this particular pen because they like to swim. So we're hoping that as the weather warms finally, that they'll actually be able to go ahead and start swimming. And we'll actually come through time to time and catch them in the water. They grow to be about 500 pounds. These are about 350.
Living flightless bird. They live in savannas and woodlands of Africa. They are known as the camel bird because of their long neck, prominent eyes, and sweeping eyelashes. Like camels, the ostrich can tolerate high temperatures and go without water for long periods of time. They get all the water they need from the plants they eat. Male ostriches are called cocks, and female ostriches are called hens. A group is called a flock. Ostriches are fast and can sprint in short bursts up to 43 miles per hour. One ostrich stride can be 10 to 16 feet long. They do not fly, but like the emu, have wings that help them balance when they run. Ostriches play with their feet, and they kick forward because that is the direction in which their legs bend. A single kick can kill a lion. The ostrich egg is the largest egg of any living creature in the world. It is very strong. A 200-pound person can stand on an ostrich egg and it will not break. One ostrich egg is equivalent to approximately 24 chicken eggs.
Species such as impala,
evening and early in the morning. They will breed throughout the year, although most young are born in spring after a gestation period of 7 months. The Nyala conservation status is currently stable. However, their main threat faced today is declining habitat due to agricultural and climate change. Wild and Wildlife Park has been working with many zoos through the animal management program to keep this species thriving. The Oryx antelope, also known as the white antelope or the screwbird antelope, are from North Africa. The Oryx is a desert antelope that is built to survive extreme temperatures in areas where there is little rain. They have white coats that help keep them cool by reflecting the sunlight. They are social animals and like to live in nomadic herds, which is led by a dominant male. Both the male and females have twisted horns that can grow almost 3 feet long. Males can weigh up to 300 pounds and females weigh up at about 250 pounds. The Oryx has flat hooves, are like snowshoes. They keep the animal on top of the ever-shifting sand so they do not sink. They are not nocturnal, but even so, during the hottest times of the summer, they will sleep during the day and forage at night. They are herbivores, which means they only eat vegetation. These animals do not have a particular breeding season, and they can breed throughout the year when conditions are good. The female has a gestation period of 9 months, giving birth to a single calf. The Oryx is just about as close to extinction in the wild as it possibly can be, and is classified as critically endangered. Due to the great loss in numbers and destruction of much of their habitat and natural range, it is feared that in some areas that it may be too late to save the species in the wild. Oryx can be found in many private public zoos worldwide, and as part of conservation breeding programs across the world. These programs are put in place for the true survival of the species. It may be possible to reintroduce the Oryx to their native areas through these programs.